Hey, what's going on, everybody? Your boy DJ City Manos, and I'm gonna explain. I'm gonna show you guys what's in my crates. A lot of you guys wanna know what's in my crates, and I told you guys before, I don't have nothing in my crates. So check this out. I know somebody else also asked me, how do I know this is your boy DJ City Manos? Here's the OG picture. That's me right there. Check it out. I got the crates in the background. I got my equipment. You know, I got my little monitor right next to me. This is like years. I was maybe in my 20s. I'm 51 years old now. That was a long time ago. But anyways, what's in my crates? So, your boy DJ City Manos doesn't do this. Check this out. He has a YouTube channel. Everybody does this. That's fine. You guys can do whatever you like. Like right here, they got mixes, club, hip-hop, R&B, house. People does this. They do. You guys do this, right? A lot of people do that. I don't do that. What I do, I use my crates for mixes. Check this out. I don't know if you can see this in the picture. If you see the picture way in the background, you see the records are up. You see the way the records are up? I got my set ready to play. That means I got a mix ready to go. And back in the days when you about to go, because it was me, right? If I'm going to play, I get my records ready and I put them up, ready to go. I leave them in the crate, but I put the records up. And then when it's my turn to play or I'm playing, I'm doing my set, I get the record, play it, and then grab the next record. You know, and I get them ready. So I always put my records ready to go. Instead of going digging through the crate, looking for the songs. So basically, when you guys have a bunch of songs like that in the crate, that right there is a crate full of records. I kind of don't like that. Because you got to scroll down. So what I do with my crates, I actually do mixes. I call them mini mixes. So like right here, let's click on Get It. I call this my, this is the one I did I started off with Too Short. And then I went into Ja Rule's Big Papa, Posse on Broadway. Here goes something right here. I got five on it. I added that song, Boys in the Hood, California, Family Affair. Now I'm gonna show you something right here real quick. You see the colors? Here's what the colors represent. Oops, my bad. Here's what the colors represent. So the birthday girl sent me a playlist, and she sent me a playlist through Spotify, and I transferred the playlist over to Tidal. Here goes her birthday right here. I put the date on it, so I know the date. So that's what the colors means. It just means that I added in the mix. So people ask what's the colors for too. So let's put this by beats per minute so you guys can see. So I'm looking at the beats per minute. Here goes a song right here that she asked for. That's that Chisel by Snoop Dogg and R. Kelly. And another thing too, people is they're iffy about R. Kelly. Look at how many R. Kelly she asked for. She asked for 1, 2, Step in the Name of Love. This is actually R. Kelly too, but they don't say R. Kelly. He sings in the background. So she asked for like 4 songs from R. Kelly. You know? So this colors right here represents... It just basically just telling me that I put it in the mix. All this, I put them in the mix. And then it's just like a checkoff. Like I already added this to a mix. Added this to a mix. And all the other ones I didn't add to a mix. And this is what I tell them. When they give me a song, I'm up front with them. I tell them, do you want me to stick to your playlist? Or do you want me to mix some of my songs with your songs? And usually when they give me an idea of what they like, I'm like, okay. I see Family Affair. That means she likes 90s music. Music from the 90s. Look at this. Rick James, Mary Jane. You know, she asked for shh. She asked for shh. You know? So I'm looking at songs that I already did a mix before. Like, she asked for that shh. If you guys know what that song is right here, Cumbia Kings, check it out. Listen. She asked for this song. This is from Tidal. All right. She asked for shh. And let's go ahead and do this real quick. Let's put shh over here because she asked for that one. And this is what I do at my when somebody give me a playlist, I put them over here, the stuff that I could work with. So she asked for that. She asked for Baila Esta Cumbia, Selena. She asked for pan pan. She asked for quiero bailar. Juana la Cubana. So I'm putting songs right here. And when people send me a playlist, I group them together and I try to do a mix with it. Or I try to see if there's already mix created. Like this one is already having in the mix that, shh, hold on, let's focus. I already have this one in the mix. I got this in the mix. I got this already in the mix. I got that already in the mix. She asked for all these songs, so I don't even have to do anything. I just gotta go look for the mix. So I look for the mix. And then I just put it in a folder for her. So here goes focus, focus. Here goes Selena. And she asked for Baila Esta Cumbia. So that's number two, the song number two. Oh no. Where's Baila Esta Cumbia? It's not in this one. Oh yeah, here it is, Baila Esta Cumbia. Number one. And then from that when I put on Celia Cruz, I mix it into with Celia Cruz. It goes Juana la Cubana. So this song that she asking for, you know. What else she asked for? She asked for I think. See right there, that's already like three songs she asked for. Juana la Cubana, Baila Esta Cumbia. And then if I do this mix right there, she's probably gonna be happy with this mix. You know, I think she asked for Taki Taki too. Let's go back to her playlist. You know, she asked for Taki Taki. Let's look at her playlist. Let's put it in order. She asked for Taki Taki. Let's see. There it is right there. Taki Taki. She asked for Taki Taki. She asked for Suavemente. She asked for a lot of stuff that I already done mixes with. She asked for Daddy Yankee. So that's what I'm doing. I'm basically just changing the color so this is like a check. Like I already got this in the mix. I already got this in the mix. And then from there, man, four or five mixes, I could do her whole gig, her whole party, and she's happy. The client's happy. But if she doesn't want me to mix some, then if you put all these songs over here, let's get rid of these songs right here. Let's say she doesn't want me to mix them. She doesn't want me to mix them. She said, go ahead and stick to my playlist. Her gig, let's say, is 4 hours. Look at how many, yeah, it's about 4 hours. She doesn't want to mix them. Right there, it says total time. And I could just hit auto mix and just let it play. You know, but I don't want to do that. I get bored. It's like me just sitting there just doing nothing. You know, I'd rather mix them and do something. And when you mix them, you get more songs. You play more songs. Like a 15-minute mix, you could play like 10 songs in 15 minutes, you know? So, yeah, most of the stuff that she asked for, I already have them in a mix, and I just changed the colors. Like, I forgot to change that color on that one. You know, I added Mary Jane to a mix. I forgot to change the color. But I already got all these in mixes. And this one's already in the mix. She asked for that one. I don't have this one in the mix. Bottoms Up, I have that in the mix. You know? Azúcar, I got that in the mix. All Night Long, that's a jam. I got that in the mix. You know what I mean? So I just have to look for my mixes, the previous ones that I did, because I just leave them right there. Anytime I create a mix, I just leave them. I just keep on, you know, I got to look for them. Then I just add it to her folder, you know. That's all I do. I keep it simple. I just do sets. And if I want to look for the genre, like let's say I want to play country, or let's just type in hip hop. Hip hop. Let's just put 90s in there. See the way it has hip hop? Look how many songs I have from hip hop. 27. So now let's put 90s. Now, how much I got? 74. So that's the way I do my crates. I just actually add it in the tag. I tag them. For me, it's much easier than doing all this because it just give me like I said, back in the days when I had my crate and all your songs are in that crate and you're digging through them trying to find the songs, it takes forever. But if you put these in small miniature folders, it's easier to, you already got your folders ready, you just got to play them. You know what I mean? You just got to look for them. So if somebody asks, like they ask for a song, Return of the Mac, I already know I have these songs in a mix ready to go. I just click on it and I start off with, remember how, like if she asks for Return of the Mac, right away I just go here and continue from here down. And then I finish it off with Ice Cube or something. Or if she asks for Mary Jane, I start it there. And then maybe I go back and start off, Hey, Mr. DJ. Like, it's out of order, but then I would just go back. You know what I mean? And right here with Mary Jane, also, this one here has a various beats per minute. It's kind of hard because towards the end, it started going off beat. So, but this mix is already done. I don't have to do anything with it. I just go from this song and end it there. This one I haven't decided what I'm going to do with Step in the Name of Love. Actually, this song right here sounds just like Mary Jane. The beat. I hear the same beat as Mary Jane. I don't know why, but I hear the same beat. I was going to go check on, see if they sample this song from Mary Jane. Because it has the same beat, has a similar beat to it. Watch, listen. Tell me if you hear the same thing I hear. So I'm hearing the flute, right? Let's hear this one here. I'm hearing the flute. It's probably not the same flute, but I'm hearing the same beat. Hear the flute? I hear the same beat for some reason. Got the flute in there. But I gotta figure out what to do with this tape in the Name of Love. Like I said, that's what I do with my crates. Everybody do things different. For me, it's so much easier to just create little mini mixes and just go with the flow. If I have another gig, I probably make another folder and see what they want. And then if this song's already done a mix already, I just look for them and just put it in that folder. So let me give you an example. What I'll do, let's say they ask for this song right here, Blueface, and I already have it in the mix ready to go. And instead of redoing the whole thing, I just grab this, and let's say this is their folder right here. Hold on, let's see. Let's say this is their folder right here, Mandy. I just grab this and drag it over to the Mandy folder. So now I removed it from there and I threw it in here. And there it is right there, Icy. That's all I do, just move things around. I don't wanna redo the whole mix all over. I don't wanna, for me, when I see everybody when they create the R&B, that's a lot. For me, that's just like back in the days when I had my crazes. For me, it's too much work trying to look for the songs, you know? I'm gonna go through that whole, it's like I could do the same thing. I just type in hip hop, like I said. And there goes all my songs right here. And then for me, I want to be like, what do I play? What do I play? So many songs. I can't decide what to play. Oh, my goodness. There's so many songs. What should I play? You know, for me, I could say, you know what? I'm going to do this right here, this set. I already done it. This set is a banger. I've seen people react to it. They dance it. They love it. And I just stick to that playlist or that little mini mix. So this is your boy, DJ Steady Manos. Hopefully this helped out. And this is your OG, DJ Steady Manos, back in the days. Woo! La Paisa, DJ Steady Manos. And I am out. Check this out. The wires. Wire management. Back in the days. Here goes your boy, DJ Steady. There goes the Steady right there. All right. I'm out. Peace.